Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this box. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, and you're going to start out with a piece of Pacific Point cardstock, and this measures 6 by 6, and you're going to score it on all four sides at 2 inches. Okay, now fold it on your score lines. And I've got myself a template here. All you're going to do is cut here and here on both sides, okay? Okay, so I'm going to add adhesive here. Here, this piece, and this piece. So basically all of them except for this, okay? And I'm just going to fold these in just like that. And if you scored it properly, it should match up perfectly. You want to make sure that you see how this line is here. You want to make sure that this is also on the same side. So this would be the front of our box, okay? So now let's add our designer paper. I've got 4 pieces of the Celebrations designer paper, and this measures 1 3/4 by 1 3/4. I'm going to turn them all over and go ahead and add adhesive to all 4 of them. Okay, so let's add the brad to the center of the circle. We need to punch a hole in your box. Or you could use your hole punch. Let's see. It will go, this handheld one will go through 3 layers of cardstock, but not all of them will, so just be careful. Okay. I don't think I like that. So I think what I'm going to do is just eliminate this red piece. Yep. Okay, now let's do the other side. So we're just going to measure this and see. You can use the paper piercer or you can use a handheld punch. Yeah, that looks good. I like it better with the brad than the staple. But if you're in a hurry, you can use the staple. Okay, so now let's stamp our image. We're going to use the Happy Birthday from the Punch Bunch stamp set. We're going to use Pacific Point. And then punch this out with the scallop square punch. And then we're just going to add a dimensional to the back. And pop it right up. So there you have it. Isn't that cute? Thanks a lot. If you have any questions, let me know. Bye.